Welcome to Hercules Video YouTube. It's another day, and I'm happy to be with you here. Anyway, first of all, let me say that I'm so grateful you are always hanging out with me on my YouTube channel. I don't know if you're watching me from my YouTube channel. I don't know if you're watching me from my Facebook. I don't know if you're watching me from my Instagram. But wherever you are watching me, I'm so grateful for you. And I really love you. By so watching me and also liking what I'm doing, it kind of helps me to grow this channel. My name is Hercules Otieno. I'm a real estate agent with Realty Group. And my phone number is 763-498-2650. And I don't know to call myself educator or to... But normally, if you are always giving people information, you can classify yourself as an educator. So probably I might classify myself as an educator. But I think the information that I'm giving are very good. And if you follow them, in the end of the day, they'll be able to help you. And mostly I'm gearing this towards our immigrant, fellow immigrant. I'm an immigrant too. That's why I kind of gear towards you immigrants, because information is power. And with us, where we came from, not so much this information that we used to get. Actually, this was left for rich people. If you didn't come from a rich family, you didn't know even that somebody would, you would be able to purchase a home. I think so. When I was growing up, buying a home, that was a dream that you'll never even think about. That was left for rich people. And there you go. We came to this country. You come to find that you can be able to own your own home. You can be able to do things that you used to just to see them maybe on a TV, or you just used to read them on a paper. You couldn't do them real. But when you come to this country, the most beautiful country, the best country that gives you the opportunity, you are able to do it. That's why I normally try to ask our fellow immigrants. We came with a dream in this country. What happened? What happened? Why did you come in and just settle and then started just relaxing? Because one, you forgot the purpose of why you came here. You forgot why you came to this country. You either came for education, or maybe you just came to look for your better life. And then when you reach here, you get excited with what is there, and then you forget that there's some things that you need to do. Like, for example, buying a home. That is something that if it was me, because I'm sure you must be paying a rent somewhere. You must be paying a rent somewhere. If you're not paying a rent, then you're not responsible. You must own something that generates passive income for you. So that's why I talk to the people who have already owned their homes. I try to come in and tell them something. The topic of my today is the top spring projects to add to your list if you plan to sell your home. Let's say the spring is here. I'm in Minnesota, by the way. If you're watching me, I'm in Minnesota, somewhere called Brooklyn Park. And I like educating people. I like giving people knowledge, because knowledge is power. As we know that with knowledge, you can create power. So if you have knowledge, it becomes better. So today, my topic that I'm going to discuss is the top spring project to add to your list if you are planning to sell your property. So if you're planning to sell your property, adding a few spring projects to your list can help improve your home value and makes it more attractive to potential buyers. Here are some top spring projects to consider. We are in Minnesota. Minnesota, we have about three seasons, I think so. Three or four. Because we have spring. We have fall, spring, summer, and winter. Yeah, we have four. So right now, we are heading towards spring. Things are starting to get better. So what are the projects that you can be able to do? One, landscaping. That home of yours, now it's time for you to start working on your landscaping. If you can't do it yourself, get somebody to help you doing it. You can get some contractors. But sometimes you can do these things yourself, because you just need to go to YouTube and YouTube will be able to help you. Like, curb appeal is a crucial when selling a home, and landscaping can help boost it significantly. Adding some colorful flowers, trimming shrubs, and ensuring that the lawn is green and tidy can help create a positive first impression. Yeah, those overgrown shrubs that were there when the winter was there, you can be able to just trim them. Just trim them. The grass, go to Home Depot, get some, they call it what? The grass improvement vitamins, I don't know, there's some names they call them. If you talk to these landscapers, they'll be able to tell you. Number two, exterior painting. you can be able to do some painting on your exterior property. Like giving the exterior of your home a fresh coat of paint can make it look more attractive and well-maintained. Opt to neutral color that will appeal to broad range of buyers. I keep on singing and singing and singing and talking and talking and talking. Make sure you take care of your property, because taking care of your property will give you more money, because everybody would want to buy and people would be competing for your property when you put it in the market. So maintain it. Don't let your property just degrade, go down and down and down and down. Number three, deck or patio. I think I talked in one of my videos about this deck or patio. A deck or patio can add valuable outdoor living space for your home. And it's a project that relatively easy and inexpensive to complete. Make sure the area is clean and free of any damage before listing your home. I don't even need to talk too much about that. Because patio, you know, patio helps a lot. If you have bad days out there, if you have bad days, if you have guests, you can hang out there and have fun. Number four, kitchen upgrades. The kitchen is often the heart of home. So making upgrades can help increase its appeal. Consider replacing old appliances, adding new light fixtures, or installing new countertops to give it a fresh look. I think also I talked about this appliance thing. Appliances, remember, the old ones were not energy efficient. So that takes money out of your pocket. So make sure that if you try to upgrade them, and mostly if you're going to put your property in the market, make sure you upgrade your appliances, because that is very, very important. It will help you. In one way, it will save you money. Two, it will make your property be more appealing for the buyer. Number five, bathroom updates. Updating the bathroom can also make a significant impact on a potential buyer's decision. Consider upgrading fixtures, replacing old tiles, or adding new lights to give the space a modern feel. Think of it like this. If you were to buy that property, let's say you were the buyer again, what would you want to be upgraded in your property? That's how you'll be able to make a decision on what you'll be upgrading on your property. Because upgrade, yeah, it's going to get eat some money up front. But remember, it will give you back. You'll regain your investment back. So this is like doing a business. You invest on your property, and then in the end of the day, you're going to make some money. Number six, declutter and cleaning. This is always my favorite. One of the most important things you can do when selling your home is to declutter and clean thoroughly. Remove any personal items, excess clutter, to make the home feel more spacious and invite. Right now, the cities are taking the trashes away, and they're also taking this stuff that are cluttering the homes. Take them. That old mattress, take it away. The old couch that you don't like, take it away. All those stuff that are scattered in your house, go to the city and throw them away. Don't let your property become a much cluttered place with everything. Some people you'll find like that. It's like they're hoarding their house. It's bad to use that word, but anyway. Don't be hoarding your property. That is your investment. If you want to take care of your investment, you must maintain it. I relate to the way we were growing up. My dad used to tell me, if you want when you take your cow to the market, if you want your cow to sell, you have to make sure that it looks fat, it looks healthy, and it looks nice. Then everybody will scramble, want to buy it. It's the same as your property. How I'm relating that is your property. You have to take care of your property too. In other words, you want to take care of your cow for it to sell. And then now you also have to take care of your property in order to sell. So these are things that you have to make sure that you do. Overall, these projects can help boost your home value and appeal to potential buyer. Remember to keep your budget in mind and focus on projects that will make the most significant impact. I don't know if these things make sense. I don't know if they make sense. But mostly, I don't know how you feel, but you immigrants, you're the people I talk to so much, because you're like me. There are things that we are learning out in this country. But if somebody knows them, like me now, I have developed some knowledge. I've gone through them and I've been learning them. Why should I not share them with you? If I'm sharing them with you, I feel good. If you want to take your time to listen to me, that's good. Yeah, if you want to take care of, if you want to listen to me, go to my podcast. I have my podcast, Hercules Real Estate. I always post it on my YouTube. Or you know what? What you can do, if you go to my Facebook, which is Hercules Otieno, just shoot me a message and then I'll send you a link. Or you can go to my Hercules, the realtor, that's my business Facebook account, and then I'll be able to send it to you. LinkedIn, I always send it there. Just send me a message. 763-498-2650, that's my phone number. And I'm a real estate agent with Realty Group. So if you want, you know, you can promote me, because the way you're promoting me is by so downloading my podcast, watching me on my YouTube channel, and listening to this good information I give. I don't know if I'm giving good information or not, but I think I do. So I want you, what I want you to do is listen to these things I'm telling you. Knowledge is power. If you have knowledge, you have power. No knowledge, no power. No power, no money. No money, you're broke. Thank you very much for watching me, and I hope to see you next in my video, and I hope that you have a good day.